Yeah.
Check 1, 2. Yeah, didn't feel much at all, actually. The taste of it was maybe the most impactful. Didn't taste great. Yeah.
As the keto diet gets more popular, a number of keto-related products are coming onto the market. Exogenous ketones are one of them, a supplement that claims to boost up your level of ketosis and, by doing so, increase physical and mental performance, improve mood and energy levels, and reduce hunger and brain fog. But do they work? With the help of some of the Diet Doctor team members, we're going to put some ketone supplements to the test and find out if they really do have all the benefits they claim to. Hi, my name's Kim. I'm here in the Diet Doctor kitchen in Stockholm. Today is day one of the ketone supplements experiment. So what we're doing here now is we're going to mix the different supplements that we have. We're only going to give them a number so that our test subjects don't know which supplement is which. And that's also really important because one of the supplements is actually not a supplement, it's a control. We're just going to use this sweetened drink that says it's got natural colours and flavours to have something that tastes a bit like a ketone supplement but isn't actually one. And our subjects are not going to know which one's which. If there are any effects from the ketone supplements, whether those effects are down to the ketone supplements or whether there's some other factor that's causing them. So this is number one, it's the Prüvit KETO OS Max. Number two is going to be the control. And then we have a Ketond Advanced Ketone Blend. That's number three. We have Prüvit KETO's Chocolate Sea Salt Base Ketone Supplement. And then we also have this powder from Kegenix Prime. So we're just going to mix those according to the manufacturer's instructions. And then they'll be ready for our subjects to drink. Each day of the experiment, I mixed four of the drinks, one for each of the team members taking part. We ran the experiment over 5 days so that each person tested each drink once.
So now we have our four supplements ready. This is number one, the Prüvit KETO Max. This is number two, which is the control. This is number three, which actually needs topping up. That's the Ketone Advanced. And then this is the Prüvit KETO Chocolate Sea Salt one. Our test subjects think that there are five ketone supplements. They don't know that one of them is a control. So we're trying to make this one taste as much as possible like the other ketone supplements. So we are now going to go over to our team members. We're going to do a physical test, a mental cognition test, and a ketone test, both before and after taking these supplements. So let's go over and meet the team and we'll get the test started.
It's time to meet our team Diet Doctor test subjects.
Cheers.
Cheers, Chico.
Cheers.
Bottoms up.
Diet Doctor Couches. This is where we hang out, have our coffee breaks. But today we're here because we're going to start rolling with the ketone supplements experiments. So, Georgos, you're going to start with cognition today. Emeke, you're going to start with push-ups. Jonathan, you're going to start with the questionnaire. And Eric, you're going to start with testing your ketones.
Okay.
Let's do it. Woo. Over 5 different days, the team members will run through tests both before and after taking the supplements to check blood ketones, physical performance, and mental cognition. They'll also answer a questionnaire asking them about hunger, energy, mood, brain fog, and taste. We'll compare the results to measure the effects of the supplements.
That was the sweetest thing I've had in like a year and a half.
Wow.
The full dose.
Approved.
I recommend to friends and family.
Even though I like the taste of the supplement, it was surprisingly good. After I drank it, I felt quite a bit nauseous, and also I got extremely hungry, which it's like a monstrous hunger that came over me. I haven't felt like that in months, I would say. So I didn't have such a positive experience, to be honest.
Yeah, didn't feel much at all, actually. The taste of it was maybe the most impactful. Didn't taste great. The supplement I tested was, I think the flavor was chocolate. Didn't say, but that's what I reckon. I didn't feel perfect later on the evening, but a couple of hours later, it was okay.
No, I felt nothing special at all. The only thing I felt was a little bit of hunger, and it didn't feel very nice to my stomach. And that lasted for a few hours, I think, till I went home. And it was very sweet, and I would probably blame this nauseous feeling to the sweetener because I'm not used to that. But again, I don't know, I'm just saying.
I didn't feel very much, to be honest. I don't know what the reason was for it, but maybe I felt just a bit less energetic. I've had this small nauseous feeling, just a tiny sensation.
I tend to be suspicious of companies that promote a supplement as an easy alternative to lifestyle changes. Ryan Lowry does research on ketone supplements and is listed as a specialist on Prüvit's website. I wanted to ask him how he recommends using the supplements.
I think real food and whole foods is key. It's the priority. I think getting people closer and closer to that is absolutely essential. The key is also to figure out how to make this lifestyle sustainable. I'd rather provide someone with tools and resources to make sure that they're able to sustain this for a long term, rather than, hey, I'm just gonna do this diet for a couple of weeks and then go back to my old ways. I think ketones can be one of those options, but make sure you're not utilizing those every single day and relying on them as a crutch and eating all these sweets and sugar replacement things all the time.
Thank you.
9.
How many did you?
Admittedly.
I did 49.
Oh my god.
How many did you do?
28.
What? Fair time. Just say the number. Just say the number.
You don't want to hear it, Jorgen. No. It was only 51.
It's the end of the experiment. Yay!
So what did the test subjects think about the experiment?
Well, I thought it was pretty fascinating because I didn't know what to expect, and I think probably maybe or maybe not I was one of the participants with the least bias, so to speak, maybe knowing that there should have been some sort of drastic improvements both physically and mentally. And not sure that ever happened. So I actually made a wild guess which one was the placebo, and it turned out I was right. It was obviously the one that had the best taste. I would recommend these ketone supplements to my friends and family once they have so much money, they just don't know what else to spend it on.
It was kind of fun to do the experiment with the science, right? I don't think I would be able to tell any difference from the results on either one, even though one was a placebo. But I don't know, for some people it might work better than for me.
Yeah, it was fun to be part of it, for sure. I was very curious. I still am very curious about like seeing the final result of the experiment we did. And it was just fun to do it, you know, on a random day here, all of us. Colleagues and friends, just taste some supplements and, you know, see what happens. Well, I can tell for sure that I haven't noticed any positive effects, but negative effects, maybe it was one for sure, maybe two, if I try to look back and remember now. Maybe there were two supplements that, like, made my stomach a little bit upset. All of the 5 days that we did ketone supplements experiment, I was fasting, so I took all the supplements in on a fasted stomach.
I didn't really enjoy any of it. Well, it was fun competing with some of the other employees, like doing the physical activities. I could watch the difference in ketones afterwards, and some of them were better, of course, but aside from that, no. I noticed from a few of them, maybe one or two, I noticed that I got this bit of nausea, and I can't say that I felt that with all of them. So, yeah, that was probably the only thing.
We were unable to show that the supplements had much effect on any of the markers we tested. On average, there were small increases in mental performance and moderate increases in mood when comparing the supplements as a group to the placebo. There was no difference in brain fog, and there was a small decrease in energy levels. In fact, the supplements were associated with a big decrease in physical performance, and even more surprisingly, blood ketones had only increased by an average of 0.3 1 hour after taking the supplement. You can see the full write-up of the experiment, plus the breakdown of the results for the individual brands on dietdoctor.com. What do you think about the way that ketone supplements are marketed?
So unfortunately, ketone supplements, when they were brought to market, were marketed as, hey, drink this, lose weight. And that's really not the intent, and that's really not what they do. And I'm glad that now more and more research is coming out showing that here's the real benefits of exogenous ketones. Here's where they may have application. It's one of the reasons we're looking into traumatic brain injury and some of these neurological deficits where a lot of it's impaired glucose metabolism. And if you provide a fuel source that is superior, like ketones, that your brain can still take up and utilize, you do see improvement. So that's where the research needs to go. I think there's a lot more being done in the right way, scientifically, to really analyze what they do, what they don't do. But people just need to be careful when they see these claims being brought out of like, hey, drink this and you're instantly gonna lose weight. That's not the intent. Nothing in the world that you take that you're gonna be able to drink and instantly lose weight. I haven't seen any product in my entire life that can do that.
Our conclusion? You don't need to spend money on products to revolutionize your health. Just enjoy real, delicious, low-carb food. Get plenty of sleep, some exercise, and reduce stress. And remember, when the way a product is marketed sounds too good to be true, it probably is.